My name is Steinar Norman Bjungen. I'm coming from Norway, southwest of Norway. What I'm doing for a living is developing the drone market, the flying machines, autonomous vehicle market. Developing this in Norway, and we are establishing services and also selling machines. So we have the Scandinavian market, a company called EHang Scandinavia. Well, me and my partner got to know EHang 2-3 years ago, so we have been developing the relationship, building on trust and getting to know each other, the product, and then see the market. We could work together to move forward, because we find that we share the same vision, the same dreams about autonomous vehicles in the air. My background is many years. I've been working in the oil and gas industry, global, for a company called BP. You probably know that. Working project management and corporate management for the last 25 years. Now I saw there was a chance, 2-3 years ago, to go into a different market, using my experience to build up a company. Yes, the oil and gas industry, we have been working also to electrify all the plants out in the sea. So it's about getting more and greener and greener, coming from a more polluting industry. And then, of course, but it's the customers. I mean, it's the cars, it's the vehicles. It's, today is a lot of petrol based and ships, but we need to change that. So I think it's a huge opportunity as soon as we start to have a really good products on electricity. And in Norway, as you know, we have a lot of water and a lot of power plants based on water energy, so we can have a green loop, having a electric transportation based on hydro power. Well, I've been looking into both autonomous buses and autonomous cars, but we are building roads all the time. As soon as this road is finished, it's already too small because the capacity, more and more cars, more and more vehicles on the roads. This taking the airspace into use, transporting people within this approved kind of operating envelopes where we transport between cities and airports, between urban centers and more remote in the cities, instead of spending hours in your car sitting waiting, we go point to point, straight lines in the air, much safer actually, and also much faster and more clean. So I think we need to do something, because building more roads, more tunnels, more bridges, for instance in Norway with all the fjords, it doesn't solve the problem, but taking the airspace into use is fantastic potential, both for transporting goods and then also eventually people. So we will do this step by step, starting with logistics and transporting goods, and then eventually also people. I think that we are going for a combination. I think that the strength in our product is also the ecosystem, where you have this common technology platform, like Internet of Drones, where you share all the data, where you have a command control center as the backbone of the whole solution. And then developing that, you can also deliver services, also services from a control center, service as transport service, transporting goods or people. So I think that the whole ecosystem is the backbone of this sector, which we will develop. And I think some of these markets are potentially there. They're looking into this. We can transport between hospitals and hospitals, between ships to platforms, between harbors to ships, and so forth. So it's like 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 huge sectors where we can start to use this this service. It is the future. So the combination between the control command service, where we also could coordinate other drones, other operators as well. I think the CAA, the area authorities and regulators see that there's going to be so much traffic in the air that we need to have a coordination service. And of course, we are doing this together with the authorities because they need to learn, we need to learn, we need to expand and develop the regulations as well, improve and so on. So I think the approach we are doing now is very much similar to the regulations for the oil and gas industry, very strict. The aviation is very strict, so because we will not risk any hazard that we have clashes between systems. So air traffic, the regular air traffic, we are in a different operating envelope. We are staying lower, we are staying out of their channels or corridors. So I think that's a huge potential in many areas. I think people growing up today, or even in a few, not so many years, when you go into a big plane and there's a person in the cockpit, you will say, probably ask, why is there a person in the cockpit? So because when people get educated, we'll do that by flying more, explaining what it is, develop it and learning together. And when people get used to it, they will see, okay. And if you see the accidents, whether it's cars or air traffic today, it's the human factor which is actually the highest risk. So I think autonomous, it's much safer. We believe it's safer. We know it's safer when you look at the big planes as well. So I think having the human controlling the or minimizing the human factor, it's adding safety, and I think people will really understand that. Also see with the cars as well on the road. No, but I'm not a pilot, but I've been interested in aviation since I was a small kid. And also when you get to know the machine relation, which I've been reading about, and of course in the oil industry is a lot of digitalization. It's a lot of now talking about sharing data, Internet of Things, the whole technology. So I think because I've been a technology geek, if I can use that word, for many years, trying to stay updated, try to have the latest versions of things, looking into the future and potential. So in the oil and gas industries, it's been a lot about pioneering as well and being entrepreneurs. Seeing this, seeing new markets, I think that's fantastic. And that's the main thing of actually working and developing.
Are you a game too?
Yeah, I mean, for instance, my colleague, my partner, we started with looking into the electric cars very early. He was the first in Norway selling Teslas, like ordering Teslas in 2007, 2009. So, because we believe in the future. But it's also about when you come to a point that you shouldn't talk that much, you should start to practice. Because I think we develop the road, of course, as we move forward, by learning. So things kind of doing by learning, I think, it's, or learning by doing, I think that's approach that's